the South Coastal Hockey League.
Here come the Rangers trying to make something happen. Bobby Donahoe comes in, shot, score.
Oh, what a beautiful shot.
The South Shore's premier Masters Hockey League.
Scott Kelly coming up the near side, top of the circle. Goal!
Featuring the legends.
Mike Simon go off to the net. Simon, oh, what a save by Rick Kelly. Net Brinkman gets a break, goes to the net and scores. Jerry, come on, Phantom. Oh, we'll pick it up for the Canadiens. 5:20 to go. Harnish in front. Nice maneuver. Martin scored. 9 for second after tonight is Jim Stone. What a save. Across Antoni. The shot. Oh, Jeff Holstein.
Get ready for South Coastal Hockey. The game of the week. Two teams will battle it out for a chance to hold the South Coastal Cup. Game on.
It's South Coastal Hockey this week, the pregame show.
Let's join the South Coastal Hockey broadcast team and their guests for some insight into what's happening this week in the South Shore's Premier Masters Hockey League.
It's South Coastal this week, the pregame show.
Brought to you by Fallon Ambulance. We're driven to care.
Now let's join the South Coastal Hockey broadcast team.
Okay, guys, what's up?
And welcome to championship night in the South Coastal Hockey League. We already have one champion crown in the Classics Division. We'll bring you the Legends Division matchup. It's the Saints and the Sharks, the top two seeds. So join Bill Sartell, Director John Grabowski, and the rest of our South Coastal Hockey League broadcast team. I'm Mark Ducharme. We'll bring you all the play-by-play action. It's the Saints and the Sharks, next on the South Coastal Sports Network.
This broadcast of the South Coastal Hockey Game of the Week is brought to you in part by underwriting from Inkstone Printing, Commercial Printers of Brockton, Hospitality Mutual Insurance of Westboro, Fallon Ambulance, Rockland Athletic Supplies, Dr. John Parker of the Parker Chiropractic Offices in Hanover, Panera Bread, the Sunshine Pool Company of Pembroke, Frano & Frano, CPAs of Braintree,
the new Schick Hydro for your skin,
That Bloom in Place, Route 53, Pembroke, by Holly Tree Dental in Hanover, and by Stephen Lee Jewelers of Quincy Square.
Get ready for South Coastal Hockey, the game of the week.
Tonight's goaltenders for the Saints Sharks Legends Division Championship matchup in the South Coastal Hockey League, brought to you by Stephen Lee Jewelers at Jewel of a Save. Rick Kelly starts for the Sharks, and then Barry Kaiser comes in for the last two periods. The Saints go with Justin Stratton, with Bill Sartell and Mark Ducharme. As welcome to Saints Sharks action in this Legends Division. These two teams met twice during the regular season. They split, but before, got to bring up the first game tonight because that was a dandy, Bill.
That was a great game, Mark. An overtime win for the Bruins. Their first championship since 2007, 4-3. They beat the Canadiens in overtime. The Canadiens came back and tied it late on a very nice goal by Tim McChrystal. And John Zimmer for the Bruins, who I think we gave the unofficial MVP to. I think he had a goal and two assists.
And 2-2.
Yeah, and it was just of course, the third goal for the Bruins was a power play, and an unfortunate penalty for the Canadiens, and the Bruins were able to capitalize on it. So it was a great game to watch, back and forth. And I really thought we were going to go for a shootout when it was halfway through the overtime, with nobody in. But this should be just equally as good. The Fighting Saints have never won the championship in the Legends Division. The Sharks have only won one championship. So this should be a pretty interesting game. And if I was the Saints, I would have had a meeting in the locker room about taking it to them early, taking it to them quick, and really push them. And don't let the Sharks get into any type of a rhythm, because all year long the Sharks have really had a little difficult time scoring goals. So I think the Saints, really, if I was them, I would have put it on them real early.
That's what has been the Sharks' problem. Only the Blackhawks have scored less than them in the regular season. That the two divisions. Saints, well, they were probably the definition of a streak team. Win the first eight, lose the next four, and then it was just a matter of splitting the last two. But then last week, they win their playoff game as they defeated the Crusaders. But the one thing that the Saints, who lost in the finals last spring of the Crusaders, they didn't have is the guy out in the ice, Jimmy McNeil. Jimmy McNeil just was not able to play in that final game. But tonight he is here, and that's going to be an interesting
story. Makes a difference because, I mean, Jim McNeil is a strong forward for the Saints, and he's got some speed. He's got a pretty good set of hands. But it also is a trickle-down effect because now you're able to set your lines up the way you want them. And like anybody, any team in South Coastal, when you're missing a couple of bodies, what happens is it trickle-down effect to all the lines. People aren't getting used to playing with somebody they haven't played with. And That's what happened last week in the Blackhawk game. Their two of their stronger offensive players, Vinny Joyce and Bruce Humphreys, both missing, and that altered all three lines in the Blackhawks, and it definitely showed in the way that they played in their playoff game. They just couldn't put any offense together.
McNeil tries to go wide. McNeil tries to rip it back for John Graham. Goes past him. Bill Langrell out at center ice, dumps it back in. Bill Hinchey and Jeremy Converse, the officials for this one, as Tommy Kral comes out of the zone, as his pass deflected up to Freddie Bickford at center ice. The two games between the two were both decided in close fashion. 2-0 Saints the first one, 2-1 Sharks the second one. As Kelly gets shot on for the first real shot of the game.
Really?
Charlie Ryan just nailed it off the shoulder of Rick Kelly. 1-0 Saints.
One goal, one shot, one goal. And basically what happened is Chuck Ryan came in on Rick's left-hand side, and as Rick was on his way down, and Rick's a big man. He takes up a lot of net, and it did make it over his right shoulder into the top corner. And it wasn't like the thing was loaded with Goulden's mustard. It wasn't a hard shot. It just happened to find its way at the right time. And Rick's frustrated. I think he thinks he might have been off his angle a little bit. He just banged his stick on the post, and he might have been a little bit too far off to his left side. And that's all it takes, is just that little bit of a difference off the angle.
John Curry gets an assist on the goal, but Rick, I think, was surprised. I think he thought that the shot was going to be more down as far as the height of the shot. I think it spun up. It was just like a rising fastball in on Rick, and he, you know, to take a baseball term, I think he got caught on it. As the Saints lead the Sharks 1-0. The Sharks are a team that, you know, they get a, they don't make it pretty.
They do.
They make it, they want you in a muck, ugly, you know,
they don't
fight or something like that. And they just do little things to drive you up the wall.
They don't really present themselves with a lot of flow. There's not an even up and down. But they're in the championship game. They win their games. They do drive to the net. And as you say, they do score the ugly goal. There's no doubt about that.
There's not a guy in this. I mean, if there's one guy that's good, dictates the tempo to me for the Sharks, it's always Mike Zuccarelli.
Mike's nothing but hustle.
Ryan coming back. Ryan feeding it across for Todd Roach. It goes past him. Roach trying to dig it free, as Roach actually picked up the pass from Frank Elwood, shot it wide. Tommy Shaughnessy trying to bear in, and Harry Denley gets knocked away from him. The Saints have those pretty goal scorers out there. Todd Roach will do his job. John Toms from the defense, he makes things happen.
He does. And this is his last game of the Saints. John Toms isn't renewing for the next half.
As Justin Stratton grabs the shot and ties it up.
First shot on goal for the Sharks. It comes with 7:53 left in the first period. And actually, it looked like it was just going a little bit wide. Justin just stuck the glove out, caught it, and held on to it. But John Toms is not going to renew the next half. He's going to let his body heal up a little bit. He'd like to come back in the fall of 2012, and he'd actually like to move up to the Classic Division, which we'll certainly let that happen when we get the opening there. And so this is his swan song for the Saints, and I'm sure he'd like to go out with the championship trophy, same as everybody else that's on both benches tonight.
And Toms could skate in the Classics. He's got that. You know, he's still good size. He's got some speed. And you just saw him, you know, catch the wall right there and win the battle easily.
Yeah, it looks like him and Mike Valenti going for it. And
as Graham's clear out pass, Zuccarelli gets it, dumps it back in. Zuccarelli, no, the reason I go with Mike Zuccarelli is I think he sets the barometer for the Sharks. There are little things. He knows when to rush up the ice. He's very smart, you know, when he makes things happen.
Oh, he does. He is. He is their motor. He's their on-ice captain. He's not actually their official team captain, but he's their on-ice captain. He'll motivate them. You'll hear him yell at them. There he is. Just look at him sneaking over the blue line, the jump in the play right there, and now getting back to make sure there wasn't a breakout to Spillane. So
Zuccarelli goes back for the loose puck. Yeah, Spillane bears in on him and slowed it down. McNeil couldn't pick it up. As Valenti, now it's Dolan Bainey. Dolan Bainey, Camerata, those players just, those are the guys in front of the net, just get the dirty goals. As the puck tied up by Rick Kelly. 6:43 go in the opening period. Charles Ryan gets the goal for the Saints. Lead 1-0.
Both teams in a feel-out process, and if you will, because nobody's really set up in the other team's zone. We've got that one shot that just went up over Rick's shoulder. The Sharks really haven't set up at all. And they're just trying to find their way right now and hope for their best. And obviously, they all know the importance of the game because they were all outside their locker room watching the Bruins-Canadiens final. Oh,
that was a marvelous game. That was just, it was one of those, you will, you know, there was, we only do one game a week, as Blahinchy with a whistle and a hand pass. But we only do one game a week, but there are games in this league that, you know, when we're away, if other games we bring you the updates on. There's some that are just, you come into the rink and you hear everybody talking about, and the Bruins-Canadiens championship game is going to be one that's going to be talked about for the rest of the 2011-2012 season.
Shot by Jay Fahey off the right wing board there that handcuffed Justin Stratton, but he was able to just push it off into the corner.
As Ryan trying to go down the middle.
Nice man.
He has the feed off, and the shot taken by Murphy. Knocked down by Rick Kelly. Murphy picks it up, tries to go to the front of the net. Artie Riccio for Jay Faherty. Ahead for Richard Petrosino. This is, might be the best line for the Sharks. Petrosino shot. Sticked away. Stratton and out of play. That line does a lot of nice things. They always seemingly get a goal every
Complement each other. It's a good line as far as their skill set goes. Rich Petrosino is a smart hockey player, plays well on the wall. Jay Fahey presents that line with a lot of speed and quickness, and he also is he's one to come back and help out in the back check and break the play up. And Art Riccio just is in the middle, is a death faceoff man who wins 90% of his draws, and he's always on that short side post where he just bangs it in. So they work really well together, and they are, like you say, one line in the Sharks that really plays to their skill set.
Tom's on the breakout. Up the middle it goes. Shaughnessy tips it ahead for Todd Roach, the Saints captain, coming in. Backhand shot. Pad save made by Rick Kelly. Comes out. Murphy shot. It hits off the side of the post. Actually, Tom's took the shot off the side of the post. Beckford tries to clear it out. Langrill keeps it in right at Harry Denley. Steve Sautel tries to clear it out. Oh, the shot taken by Roach. Hits off the side of the net. Todd Roach with a steal and quick shot at the net.
He was in the high position right there. He was in the high slot, and the Sharks couldn't get it out. It went right on Roach's stick, and he just fired it, and it just off the outside of the net on to Rick's glove side, on Rick's left side.
I'm going to say right now, Jeremy Converse can't be Dave Converse's brother because he just called icing. He can't be, because Dave Converse, what was Pete Senator's old line, once every millennium that he called it an icing?
Whether he had to or not.
Yeah. He said he never wanted to get down and get the puck. But also, Billy Hinchy was down the other end.
Yeah, he made Billy skate for it, right.
Yeah, McNeil tries to center across. Graham tries to swat at it. Steve Sautel
nice
ties him up.
Nice play by Sautel in front of the net, tying Graham up. He was not able to get a shot off.
And Rick Kelly can't get it.
Langrill
goes for the shot. Blocked by Tim Cruz.
Nice Langrill block by Cruz.
Drops it back. Blue line shot. Tom's. It gets off Bickford and down the other end.
Bickford was going for a change. That shot that Tom's blocked bounced right out into the Saints zone. I was wondering if Justin Stratton was going to come out and clear the puck, but Tim Cruz just didn't have the gas to get down there. And
it's a steal! Great. Nice play taken
nice
by Mike Valenti.
Mike Valenti are there.
Oh, Valenti
just low, hard shot. Kicked out nicely by Stratton into the corner, though.
John Tom's just trying to carry it through too many people. As here comes McNeil off on the right. Graham at the circle. Tries to feed it in front. Valenti skating back. Goes up the sideboards to Cruz. Cruz looks back. He just throws a bad pass. Spillane will try to knock it to the backboards and can't. As McNeil pinches in, comes around, feeds it in front. Oh, what a save, Rick Kelly.
Great
off
save
Graham.
By Rick Graham. Rick Kelly right there.
As McNeil with a shot save. Graham had the rebound, and he just flicked it wide of the corner.
Saints right now are all over the Sharks.
Those are the type of plays you got to take advantage of in this game, especially. Because you need to just put the pressure on the other team. Camarada, because it's one game, you know, for the finals.
And this is
it,
right?
It's it, yeah. You get it, you know, you take advantage. You don't let anybody off the hook. If you got control, you know, the Bruins Canadiens, it was like back and forth. And that one, it was each team getting chances, as it is iced by the Saints. 3:25 to go first period. Charles Ryan's goal has got the Saints on top, 1-0. Gee, we get a nice Christmas break, and then we come back New Year's Day.
New Year's night, opening night. There'll be some changes. We're going to have there's changes on out of the 12 teams we have. I think we have 10 teams that are going to have a different look of one player, two players at a time. And it's pretty much only the Sharks team here and the Blackhawks team in the Classic Division that are going to have no adjustments to them at all. So it'll be interesting. I think both leagues will pick up a little bit speed-wise. And hopefully a couple of teams that needed a stronger player will get them, and some other teams will pretty much stay the same as they are right now.
Curry takes the feet around the boards, taps it out of the zone. to Murphy. It was funny. I ran into Mark Tedeschi at the Red Wings last night. As he rolls it in, Kelly ties it up. Mark Tedeschi is sitting there. We're at a high school hockey game, and Mark Tedeschi goes to me and says, can you tell me who's going to be the new players on the Red Wings? I said, hey, that's Billy Sartell. I said, you know, it's a, and I would be fired. It's double, you know, one of those double secret probation things, right?
Actually, I can let you know right now, the Red Wings have a new defenseman coming into the league. His name is Mike Evenson. And they also have a new forward coming into the league. His name is Scott Varley.
So there you have it. There's part of that.
The two new Red Wings. The Red Wings lost Tim Ruthier. And they also and lost
Kenny Wingate.
Is going to play up, and Kenny Wingate's going to move up and play on the Stingers.
Yes. Faraday coming back for the Sharks. So we're just giving you a little heads up. So if Mark Tedeschi is sitting there, he knows, you know, you get a Christmas present, you know who your two new teammates are.
A forward and a defenseman coming on board to the Red Wings.
You know, they're both from Saskatchewan. They were, you know, junior. You know, as it's cleared down the other end by Frank Elwood. As going back for it is Breton for the Sharks. Breton tries to snap it off the boards. As it's taken back, is offside. Frank Elwood never cleared the zone.
Bill Langrell just carried in the zone with Frank Elwood right in front of him. You would think that they would just fire it in, let the Saints pull their make their change while the puck's in the deep end, and Billy Langrell just skated right into the zone with Frank Elwood right in front of him.
You know, it's the AARP division at times, so they forgot the glasses.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, we do kid about that, but no, there are a lot of the legends, I think, have picked up.
They have.
They've really improved a lot. We used to kid about that, you know, give them all sorts of zany remarks. But believe me, the legends have been very, very good in the last three sessions. They've been a lot of even matchups.
And they're going to get a little bit better because also Ken Wingate leaving the Red Wings and moving up, Jack Parson leaving the Maple Leafs and moving up. It's going to improve their skill set a little bit more and, you know, and make them a little bit quicker. And that's what happens. Over the years, we evolve every year in a different season. And that's just what happens in South Coastal.
As picked up, Toms goes for the shot.
Blocked by Zuccarelli. Now, again, there's that Mike Zuccarelli in the right spot. Blocked that shot from Toms.
McNeil takes the feed, gives it back to Spillane. Attempt to give and go. Goes wide. Joe McDonald tries to put the pressure on. Langrill from the blue line. Shot hard off the backboards. McNeil picks
almost
it up.
Almost looked like he was shooting that for McNeil to make a tip in on that.
McNeil battling with Zuccarelli. Toms tries to get it across as it's squeezed out in front for Toms. And Spillane, and we got a whistle behind the play.
Behind
do we have
play.
Harry Denley going off, or do
oh,
we have
it's
Spillane?
Match. I think it's a match. I think the referee Converse is pointing at both Spillane and Denley. They must going to get a match for roughing.
I was going.
One might be a slash, and one
roughing. Oh, wait a minute.
Denley for roughing. Denley for roughing. Spillane for slashing.
So. Nothing's changed with Harry Denley.
Nothing has changed in 20 years with Harry Denley.
The great we have
great guy and yes, very personable to talk to and everything, but he just doesn't quite get it during the course of a game.
But you know something, Billy, we were always saying some of the great nicknames in this league. Chainsaw is up there with Red Bull. Those are a couple of nicknames in this league. So go under a minute.
Or as they call McPherson on the Stingers, Hacksaw.
I remember that. I learned that one last week.
They do have some great names. Frank
Mike
Elwood
Ireland is foosball.
Frank Elwood on the Saints is the Wookie. So they do have some great nicknames
There's
for each other.
Some great nicknames. 47.7 seconds left in the first period of the championship game. Saints on top, 1-0. With Bill Sartell, Director John Kubowski, and Mark Ducharme, welcome to South Coastal Hockey League Championship Night. Bruins already winning the Classics in overtime, 4-3, and a great game. 1:53 left in the overtime when John Zimmer, on a wraparound, just put it in. Stratton has a nice play as he took one off the blocker. As the feed by Dolan Bainey, he tried to get it out to Sartell, instead ended up having the puck knocked back to him, blocked as Valenti tries to get it, knocked away. 13 seconds left. Kral dumps it back in.
Nice play by Tom Kral there with that reach because Paul Murphy tried to tap that around him, and he would have had one-on-one against Sartell with 10 seconds left to go in the period, and that would have been a pretty good foot race. So nice play by Tom Kral there.
Charles Ryan getting the game's only goal in the first period. We have played one period here. Bob Mock Arena, it's 1-0 in favor of the Saints. You're watching the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week, the championship game in the Legends.
Yeah. And we're back in second period action of the game of the week in the fall championship edition of South Coastal Hockey League with the Sharks and the Saints. And play is on already. The Sharks taking it into the Fighting Saints zone. But the shots on goal in the first period. The Saints outshot the Sharks 9-5. And basically the Sharks didn't really set up that well in the Saints zone. But with Mark Ducharme and our director John Grabowski, this is Bill Sautel, and bringing you the action.
Artie Riccio trying to bring it back up. As the pass, Petrosino tried to work it through the middle and it's broken up. As now it's Bertone, it's center ice. This is the Sharks' fourth championship game. As Ed Norton blocks the shot by Jay Faraday and then takes another one that Stratton just bats with the glove to the side. But they're 1-2 in the finals. Saints, only one championship. They're 0-1. But the funny thing is that puck was out of the zone by Bertone. Well, he tried to knock it back in.
And he shot it with a slap shot, which is a face-off on the face-off down into the Sharks end. And the rules of South Coastal, for those of you people that are just finding us, is anything above the boot is a whistle where the play is stopped and the face-off is in your end. It's a wrist-shot-only league. And even to clear the puck out of your zone, it can't come up over the boot of your skate. If you do happen to get three of them in the course of the game, it is considered a delay of game penalty. So in that case, where Rich Bertone stopped it at the blue line and fired it in, he did bring the stick up to his knee, almost to his waist. The referee blew it in the face-off in the Shark zone.
As Denley wins the face-off, and then it's cleared down the other end by the Sharks, icing on the play. What I was going to bring up is the fact that both of these teams have not had the luck in the finals. And the Saints were in their first final last spring. How much the Saints were the doormat.
Yes,
they when they were. Came in the league, they were struggling.
They were winless. In fact, they used to call them the Stains. They just move those letters around, and they became the Stains.
To tell you how much the Saints have improved is right now playing the shot zone. Barry Kaiser is in net, by the way, for Rick Kelly. James McNeil trying to bring it around the boards. We'll try to bring how much the Saints have improved. Is in the regular season in their seven. Now the seventh season, they complete it as Kaiser
great
makes a heck
save.
Of a play off the feet in front by John Toms and just snapped it out of the air, prevented a far side tip-in.
Great save. I'm trying to see who that was on the doorstep that went to tip that
in. Might have been Graham.
No, it was Bill Spillane. Bill Spillane took up a lot of space in front. A great glove by Barry Kaiser right there on that play. Sharks just iced it again.
Kaiser has got the great glove. But to tell you how much that the Saints have improved, all time in the regular seasons of South Coastal Hockey League in their seven seasons, they're 34-50-10.
Wow.
But in the last three sessions, how much they've improved? They're 24-16-4. They've improved that much.
And, you know, they're virtually the same team that started. There's a couple of additions. Bill Spillane was not an original Saint. But they're pretty handy to the same team. John Curry and John Toms came in afterwards. And John Curry, of course, is still pursuing his goal to play for every Legends team. I think he's halfway there.
He is. They were saying last week, they said, which uniform in the Legends you don't have? And he said, and he goes to Whalers. And the Whalers looked up. Danny Nason says, I'm not playing with them.
Yeah, so John Curry's going to stay on the Saints. But Ed Norton, he came over from the Stingers last half. But I would say out of the 16 skaters on the Saints roster, that 9 of them are original Saints. 9 or 10 of them, so they've been together for a while.
And they've gotten better. I mean, Chester Stratton, remember that first night he played? It was a fact against, I believe, the Stingers, and he was marvelous
yes.
in that game. And Justin has been the goalie throughout their sessions. It's Murphy in the offsides, Dolan Baney just ahead of the play. But, I mean, that's what the Saints have had as far as their improvement. And as you said, I mean, some people takes a little more time to develop.
Yeah, and they're used to playing. They're on a pickup hour. A lot of these guys have a pickup hour during the week, and they play together, and they're having fun. And
I'll give an example of improvement. How about the Blackhawks?
Oh.
The epitome of it is Murphy flips one in, and Kaiser grabs it and leaves it for Zuccarelli. But I remember Drew Fitzgerald said it last year. They had a meeting. They said, look, we have some of the talent. And he said, we got to play in this particular way. And they played in that particular way. They finished the regular season, the Classics in first, their first winning session in 10 years. And they were marvelous. They were the best defensive team.
They've done a great job.
Murphy brings it in, tries to fire it, gets
nice
it deflected.
Nice play by Zuccarelli. tipped that puck off of Murphy's stick.
Almost fed in front for Murphy. Toms picks it up. He couldn't get it shot off quick enough. He had it blocked. No. Tim Cruise has got two blocked shots
so far. Tim Cruise laid out there to force Toms to shoot that puck over him and wide, and that's why he went into the corner. Nice play by Tim Cruise laying out to block that shot.
Toms takes it down deep. Toms trying to curl and pass it in front. Instead takes it to the corner. Back for Ed Norton at the blue line. Norton flicked and to the side and attempted deflection. Kaiser got a piece of it. And a clear out. Murphy can't get to it because Toms just raked it away from him and dumped it to the backboards. Coletti tries to clear it out. Ryan tries to shoot it on net. Now cleared out center ice. Toms just picks it up. This is a pretty good shift as far as the Saints.
This is a good shift for the Saints, keeping the Sharks out of their zone.
And the Saints can frustrate a team with their ability to put the pressure on with their forecheck. They can make it rough on a team.
They're doing it right now. The Sharks haven't had any cohesiveness right now, and the Saints are going to end up icing it on this play. But they're going to make an outlet pass.
Yeah, Norton looked for the outlet, looked for Frank Elwood, and Frank Elwood went to the middle and. Norton's pass went to the outside. 8:16 to go, middle period, 1-0. Saints. Earlier tonight, the Bruins beat the Canadiens in the Classics Division Championship, 4-3 in overtime. John Zimmer, 2 goals and 2 assists, scored the game winner with 1:53 left in the overtime. Steve Anzoni had 2 goals for the Bruins. And Tim McChrystal had tied it for the Canadiens, sent it to overtime. Both goaltenders were fantastic.
Beautiful
in that
goal
game.
By Tim McChrystal tying that late in the third period.
But both goalies were outstanding. Jim Stone for the Bruins, Jeff Holstein for the Canadiens. They were both fantastic in the game. Todd Roach takes the feed from Bill Angrell as he's got Frank Elwood skating with him as Roach zips it up and into the blocker, Barry Kaiser.
Big hustle by Jay Fady there coming all the way back down and took that passing lane away from Todd Roach. He had nobody to pass in at the middle as Jay Fady put his head down and was just driving back into his defensive end to take away that passing lane because originally it was a 2-on-1 and Tom Crawl, the only one back for the Sharks.
Tommy Shaughnessy, one of the league gentlemen.
Yes, he truly is.
Oh, really is. He's always, have you ever seen Tommy mad? I mean, really, yeah, he's always got a smile on his face. Oh, what a feed in front and it couldn't be put in.
Great.
Valenti just got set up on the play by Faraday and he just missed the net.
Great pass by Fady to Valenti, and right in his wheelhouse, and he just missed it. He shot it high and wide.
As
Bob Uecker would say, just a bit outside.
Picked up Nelson from the blue line. Shot deflected it in.
That's in.
Billy Landgrove might have got it the tip.
Now Barry Kaiser is going to scream that was a kick in, and when they watch this game on the video replay, they'll see that the shot came from the point. It was tipped out front, and it did go off of the skate of either Spillane or Elwood, but it was not a kicking motion. It just went off his skate. He didn't kick it. I wish we had replay up here to show you that, but it was and the referee was right on the goal line. There was no question, Barry. It did go off the skate of the guy in front, but he did not kick it in.
Billy Henschy just checking with the bench to see which member of the Saints officially gets the goal, but Nelson just shot it on net and it got redirected. Langrill originally redirected it. But the Saints go up 2-0 as Artie Riccio since went up in the air. Justin Stratton on the infield fly rule makes the play, one down.
I think we'll actually call that a shot on net, even though he was reaching over the back of the net. It was an attempted shot on net. We may have to have a whole new statistic because we're almost halfway through the second period, and the Sharks have 2 shots on net in a critical game.
You know, if it was soccer, Bill.
3-12.
Well, they're going to give it to Frank Elwood.
Frank Elwood.
But
what was the other assist?
They said 12. Todd Roach got an assist, but I'll be honest with you. It was Jeff Nelson who took the shot from the blue line.
And it deflected in front, and it went right off of the skate.
And we got, let's see what's coming up here.
I'm not sure what we have here.
Jeremy Converse with a call. I don't know if we got an offside.
It must be an offside. I never heard the refs yelling that it was a delayed offside, and Harry did keep the puck in at the zone, Harry Denley, so...
Billy Henschy had a smile on his face. I think he thought that it wasn't, but he thought that Jeremy had it. But that's the call. Spillane chips it out, 2-0 Saints. Uh-oh, bad break right there. Crawl slipped and fell, but I'll give Bertone check it. Bertone recovered very nicely. Graham picks it up and rolls it down the other end. What I was going to say earlier is in soccer, you shoot it down towards the thing. They call it a shot, and then they call the other thing saves, which I always found very mysterious. I'm the hockey mind. Goalie's going to make the play. It's a shot and a save. as McNeil comes
great
in. Great play
by Barry
Kaiser to make the blocker save. So for all the soccer people who want to scream at me, don't, because that is not. No, I believe that's a shot.
That is a shot. That was a nice save there by Kaiser.
2-0, 6:23 to go, middle period. Frank Gilwood, and getting the other goal was Charles Ryan, who's about to take the faceoff. But the Saints, bringing in offside. But right now the Saints are playing Shark style of hockey, and they're beating the Sharks at their own game.
Well, they're keeping the puck in the Sharks' end. And I'm not really sure. We still have a game. We still have a period and a half to go here. But the Sharks need to have a little bit more intensity and a little bit more energy, because they just don't seem to be skating to the puck. They're not winning any puck battles at all. And right now, I mean, that was a beautiful setup from Faherty to Valenti, but it missed the net, and back in the Sharks.
But it's been few and far between for any of it, too.
It really has. They need to get some sustained pressure. They need to fire it in deep, and they need to show a little bit more intensity and emotion right now.
As Charles Ryan tips it ahead and along the boards, now Ryan gets some help from Curry. As it's now cleared out by the Sharks, and will it make it for an icing call? Is it going to make it? Oh, by about 6 inches.
And Bill Angle made an effort to get there. He just didn't take the circuitous route. He went there.
He took the scenic.
He went to get it, and it did make it.
It was a scenic route. You kidding me?
He came from the right point. So, you know, if there was he was on the right point in the zone. If there was a right wing on the Sharks, that would have really skated up that zone. It would have beaten it to him, because the puck struggled to get to the icing line. The Sharks need to step up their play, their emotion, and everything right now. They need to realize they're in a championship game.
It looks like that, like, as a shot, Tom's knocked down and grabbed by Kaiser. It looks like one of those. There's nothing. If the Saints keep it at this pace, they're in great shape, because the Sharks look like they need something. In the NHL, you know, you would look for a brawl or something, or a fight to get them going. Not going to see it here in this league. We hope to God not, but some play to get them going, and the Saints are just doing what they need to get done.
The Saints aren't exactly making tape-to-tape passes and controlling the play, but they're out-hustling the Sharks
now. That's all it is. Roach fires it in, goes wide. Elwood's got one of the two goals, picks it up, shoots it towards the net. Knocked down Kaiser. Shaughnessy picks it up, trying to get Elwood going to the net. Murphy got in the way. Roach far side, as Roach had his shot blocked. Clear out as it's brought up by Dolan Baney, and he got cut off in the play by Langrill, and he slowed the whole process down. As it's rolled in, Justin Stratton has an easy time. Has no problems just seeing the puck, grabbing it, and when he saw that his team needed a change, he just ties it up.
But the Sharks are coming over the board with what on paper would be their number one line right now. And so this would be the motivation to. They've got a face-off in the zone to the left of Justin Stratton, and this is where you would say, okay, here we go.
McNeil and Valenti on the face-off. McNeil to Nelson. Nelson just rolls it around the boards and will get it out of the zone. Coletti will skate after it. Graham on top of him. Graham forces a tough pass. It stays in the zone of the Sharks. McNeil picks it up. McNeil trying to center it. Faherty knocked it down. Faherty just did a good job in coming back. He's shown the hustle. He's been one of the few for the Sharks that has really been flying up and down the ice.
He has. He's really shown.
Zuccarelli picks it up. And Zuccarelli slowed down. McNeil knows that Zuccarelli, if he gets ahead of steam, is going to be a pain in the neck to deal with in the defensive end, and he slowed him down. Stratton sticks it to the corner as Nelson battles with Faherty, and Faherty trying to dig it free. Jay Faherty digs it free, and we got, I think, Jeff Nelson's going to go off, and this is maybe what gets the Sharks a chance to get back in this one, is they're going to say Nelson for a trip.
That was the case right there where Nelson had no idea Faherty was hustling into the corner to get the puck. Faherty won the puck battle. Nelson had no choice but to react and get a penalty for a hold. And that's exactly what that was. And that was the hustle we're talking about, in winning puck battles, and now you've caused the Saints to take a penalty.
Ryan and Murphy and Norton and Toms to kill the penalty. Petrosino, Faherty, and Valenti still out there. And Ryan wins the faceoff and chops it out. Coletti, Zuccarelli back at the points. And Ryan bears in. But Faherty comes back and has to get the pass. As it's going to be. Danny Coletti bringing in. And guess
Jay
what?
Faherty put himself offside.
But Danny and Fairness to Faherty, Coletti was having a tough time coming up the wing.
Well, he was coming up in front of the benches where all the excess snow is because of the change in lines and the stopping there to get on and off the ice. So the puck obviously doesn't slide as much, but again, there was no urgency. And Faherty had his head down. He was charging in. He was making his center net drive, and it just didn't get there.
As now Valenti sets up shop, his pass, Murphy. Toms trying to knock it free. Toms does knock it over the... But I like what the Saints did. They just swallowed up the passing lane completely in the box. They swallowed it up and said, if you get it through the box and get it to somebody, it's...
And that was a nice setup. Valenti was looking for Zuccarelli cheating in off the point, and then it just deflected off a skate out front.
Well, that time, Petrosino got it to Faherty, and he got it out to Coletti, but the pass was too hard to hand him.
Right.
Norton picks it up. Ed Norton. Ryan just tips it out.
This
group has done a great job killing this penalty so far.
40 seconds left in the penalty. The Sharks are making a change.
They're looking
for
somebody.
They're making a forward change right here.
Toms will pick it up. In a 2-on-1 situation developing.
Short-handed.
And offside is Charles Ryan.
Chuck Ryan put himself offside. The Sharks had, they were making a change, so all their players were up at the offensive blue line. The only person back for the Sharks was Tom Crawl, and Joe McDonald, excuse me. The Saints put themselves offside. 29 seconds left to go on the penalty. 2-0 Saints lead the second period with 3:05 left.
And again, the Sharks are going to have a tough time coming up the ice. Norton will flip it back. And 20 seconds to go on the man advantage. Toms, that was one of the one times the Saints have not played it well. Bickford got it in front. McDonald, however, got caught up in the play by Shaughnessy. And Toms will skate up the ice, get some help from Elwood, and clear it down. And the final 4 seconds tick off on this power play, and the Sharks did zero on this power play. Something that they could help him, get him going, and offsides.
And he looked over. Tommy Shaughnessy intercepted the pass in the neutral zone as Elwood was coming out of the box. Todd Roach stepped on his right side, and on the left-hand side, the Saint player hadn't cleared the zone yet. Tommy looked over his left and still went in, and... offside.
Now the Saints are just going right along, just doing what, just enough to win this one. They take the Bill Belichick line. They're making one more play.
They're keeping the puck 200 feet away from their goaltender right now. They're not worried about an extra pass in the offensive zone. No. They're not worried about another shot on net. They're just keeping the Sharks out of their end.
And they're doing a good job.
And they're doing a very good job of it right now.
Langrell waits, gets it past Bickford. As Denley couldn't get it, Roach just picks it up at center ice and chips it back in.
It's a very boring game to watch, but it's very effective from the Saints' point of view right now because they're just doing what they have to do.
Tries to cycle it, and McNeil has his pass blocked. Harry Denley picks it up. Denley forced to go back of the net, and Spillane right there for the Saints.
Oh.
Across for McNeil. McNeil was going to walk out in front, but he lost control, and Denley gives it to Valenti. Langrell cuts him off. And then hustling back into the play was Graham to prevent the up-ice rush and allows Jeff Nelson to pick it up with no problems behind his own net and get it out of the zone. As Steve Sartell works it across, Valenti just snaps it in. As Cruz picks it up. Normally, if you talk about Tim Cruz, you talk about somebody picking up a good opportunity in front and making things happen. But tonight, he's been more at the defensive end. That time, Cruz was tied up by Langrell on the shot that came from the blue line by Steve Sartell. Right now it is the Saints doing a good job. Langrell gets some help from Nelson. They're working around the boards. Graham just chips it out past Bertone. Under a minute to go. Second period. 2-0 Saints. They're just mucking along and doing what they need to get done. It's McNeil the steal. McNeil trying to go to the net. Bertone trying to cut him off. McNeil trying to get it in front. Spillane never got control
of
it.
Nice play by Dolabane. They're knocking away from Spillane. He was just ready to make a backhand play.
Cruz goes up after it, and then Langrell throws a bad pass. Dolan Baney flips it towards the net. Cruz, stop! Valenti! And then I'll tell you, Justin Stratton able to just recover and make the play. But if that shot was a little higher by Valenti, it's a 2-1 game. But also, I got to give Billy Langrell a lot of credit. Boy, did he just hold off Tim Cruz in front of the net. He was like a...
Justin Stratton was down. Mike Valenti had the whole net to shoot at.
Yeah.
He fired it, and I'm sitting here in amazement right above this trying to figure out how that didn't go in. They had a yawning net for him, and it just didn't go in.
One of the rare times that Artie Riekkiä loses a faceoff.
And again, the Saints just bang it out into the neutral zone. In the last minute and a half, 2 minutes, though, the Sharks have picked up their intensity. They've spent more time in the Saints' end than they have the entire game. Here's Norton reversing it to try to do that, and they just can't get it out. So the Sharks have finally woken up.
Riekkiä, but they still, except for that one little flurry, it appears to go to the third period, and they will go down 2-0 into the third period. Charles Ryan and Frank Gehl with the goals for the Saints as they go to the third. They're 12 minutes away from winning their first title on the South Coastal Hockey League Game of the Week.
The third period of the South Coastal Championship game in the Legends Division. The Sharks versus Saints. The shots on goal in the second period were 9 for the Saints and 5 for the Sharks. That's a two-period total of 18 for the Saints and 10 for the Sharks. And as I was just talking to Mark Ducharme to my right here and John Grabowski, our director, the song that was playing in the rink as we came in was the Elvis Presley song, A Little Less Conversation, A Little More Action, Please. And if that is the song for the Sharks right now, that would be perfect because that's what they need to do right now is put their head down, skate, and drive to that net and get some shots.
And Petrosino tries, and Justin Stratton comes up with a stop, and the rebound unable to be picked up by Drew Camerata as Justin Stratton just about now is, if he was in a sleep for the first cup period in three quarters, because in the last couple of minutes of this one, he's faced a couple of testing shots, which he had not faced for most of this game so far. I mean, Stratton could have put up a mannequin. That's how easy it's been for him.
It really has. But I, like we say, the last 2 minutes of the second period and the way this period has started, the Sharks have picked up their intensity. They're winning a puck battle in the corner right now, and they're pinching in along the wall on the point right now to keep the puck in the same zone. So this is what they need. This is what they have to do right now.
Spillane changing that, and we got a whistle away from the play. And I don't know. I'm trying to figure out
what
John
Toms
going off. John Toms.
No, nobody's just going into the box.
Nope.
The only thing I can think of Spillane must have touched the puck just outside the zone, because the hand pass in your own zone is legal. So that puck must have just been across the blue line that we couldn't see from here, because Jeremy Converse was in position on the blue line to make that call.
Face off to the right of Justin Stratton, 11:07 to go regulation. Saints up 2-0. And the Saints, Wayne Grill tries to get it to Graham.
And again, the Saints.
He gets tied up, and here comes McNeil. Potential 2-on-1, and he tried to spring Spillane. Instead, just flipped it a little too much on it. But Spillane recovers, gets it to McNeil. McNeil walks in. Nice
play. Great play, Danny
Coletti. Oh, if Danny Coletti doesn't make that play, you're talking possibly 3-0. And 3-0, you could almost start getting ready for this Saints victory tour.
Great play by Danny Coletti. Poke check in front, because not only did Danny Coletti have body position to keep John Graham away from the front of the net, he reached over to poke it off Jim McNeil's stick, who was coming out of the corner with the puck. So a great play by Danny Coletti. Shut down the passing lane and took away the shot.
Ryan and Denley on the faceoff after the save by Justin Stratton. Denley wins it, but it goes past Danny Coletti, race for the puck. Graham gets it. Graham coming up the ice.
Curry.
As Curry checked that. Ryan. Backhands it. Murphy had an opportunity near side.
Ryan backhanded it to the net. It went off of Zuccarelli right to Murphy. Murphy fired it wide.
Norton dumped it.
I heard the Saints bench screaming for a call with Coletti dumped Curry there, but no call made by the referees. But you could hear the Saints calling for the call.
Zuccarelli, Murphy on top of him as it gives it to Coletti. Coletti just banks it off the near side boards. Norton will track it down. Ed Norton. For the Saints, John Curry clears it out. Curry set up Charles Ryan for the first goal of the game. And it's brought back in the offsides with 9:47 left. Bruins earlier tonight win the Classics division 4-3 in overtime. John Zimmer, the game winner, 1:53 left in the overtime. And this one 2-0 in favor of the Saints in the Legends Division Championship. Charles Ryan and Frank Gehl with the goals. And it's just been a ho-hum. Saints just doing what they need to get done. Dolan Bainey has his shot blocked. Ryan tried to clear it out, couldn't. As the Sharks trying to put the pressure on, Dolan Bainey in the slot. Got a good shot off that Stratton knocked down. Cruz, Valenti, Valentin doesn't control it. Kral tries to pinch in and help out. And Nelson just swats it out. Center ice. Steve Sautel just feathers it off the board. Allowed Valenti to tap it ahead and to the backboards. Grabbed by Ed Norton for Todd Roach. Todd Roach just pushes it out of the zone. Saints look, they're content right now. It's like
they're maybe
a little too early.
I think you're right, because they should have noticed by now that the Sharks have picked up their intensity, and they have to go a little bit more than just bang it out of their zone. They've got to get it down deep. They've got to try to make some plays, because the Sharks are coming. There's no doubt about it. The Sharks are coming.
This is the best sustained pressure that they put on, but McNeil steals it. Behind with the pass to Graham. Dumps in. Got one good scratch. I mean, it's for the Saints. Mike Ryan, not here, is in front. Swung on Graham, put it right into the mask of Barry Kaiser.
Right at crossbar level. It would have been interesting to see what the referee did if that puck had gone in, because he batted that right out of the air. Right across bar height.
As Kral kicks it out of the zone, gets it ahead. Valenti turns, flips it down. Stratton dumps it behind the net. Cruz gets to the puck first. However, his pass, Graham got in the passing lane, knocked it away. It comes out. Kral steals the breakout pass, knocks it down. Shot blocked. Graham does a good job. Graham, however, couldn't pick up the loose puck. Now Langrill will. Graham for Spillane, and Spillane trying to get off to the races. Over Kral's got him cut off, and it's flipped in. And also, I believe Spillane had it above the boot as far as he has.
Not only was he hanging out into the neutral zone, he put that stick way up over the boot of his skate. He was up at his waist for that. So,
well, Spillane looked back in disbelief, but Billy Hinchy was right there. It was the easiest call he can make.
I was ready for Billy Finchie to blow the whistle before I thought he brought the stick up there to fake out the goalie and try to freeze him. And I'm sitting here looking at it saying, what's he doing?
Big faceoff, Art Riccio and Charles Ryan. And Ryan loses it to Riccio. And the shot by Camerota blocked, lead pass. Here comes Paul Murphy, cut off by Richard Patone. However, Murphy levels a shot off, and it's
on the goal line!
And cleared by Camerota and Patone. Murphy tries again, hits it off Kaiser. And Camerota, as you hear Tommy, as Charles Ryan saying, he's on it. But Charles Ryan poked one that just lay on the goal line.
That was unbelievable. Up and on the back, it sat right on the goal line, and the Sharks defenseman of Bertone and Camerota poked it out of there. A couple more whacks at it by Ryan, throwing it off the side of the net. And finally, Camerota just laid down, and it was underneath him, but he was out of the paint. He was off to the side. He was out of the paint.
Charles Ryan has been maybe the best player on the ice for both teams.
Yes, tonight he has.
He has been.
Tonight he has. Absolutely about that.
Charles Ryan's got the first goal, but he's also had a couple of shifts where he's just been all over Sharks players in their zone and just pushed the puck down low and made it difficult for the Sharks to get going. Tommy Shaughnessy steals the pass by Richard Petrosino. Bertone, knocked down by Roach at center ice. 7 minutes, 5 seconds left. Riccio coming into the offensive zone. Already slowed down the play and fed Petrosino's shot saved. Justin Stratton
trying to get up right now. Great play right there.
Camerota shot blocked in front.
There it is.
And it's a loose puck and a scramble for it. And it's in.
It's in.
Riccio.
Yeah.
It might be true Camerota.
Justin Stratton could not get to his feet, and the Sharks were humming around that net, and it would finally get it poked in.
It's either Camerota or Riccio, because they were both in the area.
I think I see Petrosino lobbying. As we've been saying, though, almost at the end of the second period, the Sharks are coming. Here they come. It has not been pretty, but it is effective.
It's a 2-1 game, 6:49 left. Todd Roach dumps it in, offensive zone. Now you look back at that Charles Ryan shot that laid on the goal line. Riccio gets the goal. As Bertone gets an assist, as does Petrosino, and Kaiser ties up the puck, 6:35 left in regulation, the 2-1 game.
And Sharks, you can tell, they've got 7 shots in this period, which is 2/3 of what they had the entire game. They only had 10 leading into this period. So They have certainly come on and taken the play away from the Saints, and the Saints either have to go back to what worked for them earlier in the period or...
Langrell, Graham provided the screen and ended up blocking the shot. Zuccarelli trying to break out of the zone. Bickford comes up the far wing side. Bickford trying to get it ahead, and Spillane gets some help from Toms and clearing it out of the zone. John Toms picks it up. John Toms goes around, snaps it in to the Shark zone. 6:10 left in regulation, a 2-1 game. If there was a way that the Saints Sharks were going to get on the board, that was how they were going to do it, with a hustle goal. And Art Riccio provided it. As Langrill goes back on the icing call, 5:56 left. Charles Ryan and Frank Elwood the goals for the Saints. Art Riccio for the Sharks. And it is James McNeil and Dana Dolandini on the faceoff. Crawl gets it from Dolandini. Dolandini just almost beheads Billy Hinchy, but couldn't get it out of the zone. McNeil's pass comes across the middle, and Cruz is right there to pick it up, right on the tape of Valenti. Valenti backfires it. Justin Stratton grabs it out of the air and ties it up. 5:39 left. And if you look at back a little segment, two things. Earlier in this period, when the Saints just get it out and ho-hum dumped it down, the way they dumped it down, looked like they were, you know, going back and just trying to play defense at that little segment, and then also the Charles Ryan shot and hit the goal
line. Absolutely.
Yeah,
they looked like they were content. They were content where they were, and they were just, but the Sharks, there's another puck battle just won right now by the Sharks. Tim Cruz in the corner.
As it's attempted feet in front, knocked away by the defense of the Saints. Toms kicks it ahead as he rolls it into the Shark zone. Crawl, knocked down, kept in. Very nice shot. Murphy fires it. Toms provided the screen, and Kaiser able to grab it and tie it up. Toms is a pretty big guy, go in front of the net, but Barry Kaiser able to see the puck well enough to grab it and tie it up.
And the shot was a little high. That shot would have been a little bit lower. That shot was a little high. Toms was skating through the front of the paint as Barry was trying to get out on the top of his crease. That it was a shot for the Saints. The Saints have fallen off. They might have thought it was a regular season game with only the two periods.
Well, and they've tried to pick it up here, and it's not the easiest thing to do is to pick it up again. Ryan, what a save! Murphy again shoots it wide, but what a feed, Charles Ryan, for Paul Murphy as soon
game
as they said that.
Save right there.
Ryan measures it, hits the post!
Hits the post?
Charles Ryan is just, you could see him, he's just, oh, what did I do? He thought he had it all measured and was putting it in the net. He had Barry Kaiser beat. Ryan keeps it in. Murphy slides it across. Can Curry get to the puck in time? No. Cruz gets it. Clears it down. We're in. Norton picks it up. Charles Ryan's luck in the last few minutes has been ugly. Offsides is Charles Ryan right there, and it's John Curry poked it in. But, I mean, Charles Ryan flips one off Barry Kaiser and lays on the goal line. Charles Ryan then hits the post. I mean, Charles Ryan must be going like, oh, my God, what am I going to do?
Point blank, he had him, and Barry gave him the right side low and hit it right off that right side post.
Do you think, I don't want to be near, as I said last week, there are people you don't want to, you know, you go home and leave the rink. Charles Ryan may be one person tonight you don't want to be next to driving out of this parking lot tonight. It's Tommy Shaughnessy flips it in. 4 minutes and 12 seconds left in regulation. 2-1 Saints. Faraday comes back. Faraday carries it in. Nice move. As Riccio provided a little avenue. Petrosino shot gets blocked before he could ever take it. Stratton just got the pad out there.
Nice setup by Faraday and Petrosino. Faraday cut across his own. Petrosino went to the post. Faraday back in it in there. Just couldn't get it on net.
Todd Roach trying to just wheel it out and does. Gets it to center ice. Faraday. If there's somebody who's provided a lot of energy for the Sharks, it's been Faraday.
Absolutely. He was a guy back in the neutral zone to prevent anything from the Saints from coming out.
Shaughnessy trying to get control. Tommy Shaughnessy can't backhand it out. Riccio shoots it. Blocked. Nelson grabs it. Nelson for
here
Roach.
We go. Here
and
we go.
Tommy Shaughnessy.
Tommy Shaughnessy.
And Richard Petrosino.
Little problem. They had a little issue on the boards. Tommy didn't like the way Petrosino was on him, and before the play, Tommy gave him a little stick to the rib cage. Petrosino retaliated. Tommy retaliated, and Petrosino retaliated once again, and by then everybody had seen it. Matching penalties for the rough. 14 white rough.
I'll tell you, those are two people you don't expect to see in the roughing department.
No, that was a legitimate rough on by both of them.
What did we say earlier? Tommy Shaughnessy's always got a smile on his face. That's the first time I ever saw that with Tommy.
Championship games.
Yeah.
Brings it out in everybody.
Those nastiness in it. You know, they might have been discussing the Christmas shopping options. Who knows? I don't know. I mean, no.
What do you mean you didn't get me a present?
Yeah, what do you mean? Good grief. McNeil.
Oh, there's a hook in a... Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, Shaq's getting a penalty right there.
Danny Coletti was water skiing on McNeil. He finally let go of the rope, but it still stayed out straight. There's no doubt about it.
Oh, I like that description. I will not ever... That is...
And I used to teach my kids when I was coaching them all the time, no water skiing. Move your feet.
Exactly.
Don't hang on. And it just looked like he was water skiing.
16 with the trip.
We're going to call it a hook.
Hook trip.
We're
Take your
call
choice.
It a hook. It's a when it shows up on video, it's a hook.
Take your choice.
5-on-4 power play for the Saints now. Huge power play.
What I'm thinking is, if you're the, you know, the Saints, is the fact that you can keep it in. Well, you want to keep it in. Even if you, whatever, you want to get, you know, build some momentum to the
you
end
and
make
run
it
that
tough.
Mid and
yeah.
30 off the clock. You want to keep it in the Sharks' end, but you don't want to make any stupid plays with it. And right there was a mistake by the Sharks for letting this outlet come right up the middle.
As it's brought in, and it's bouncing off Camerata's skate to the backboard. Zuccarelli, you want to, it sets up a situation, too, down the stretch where you want to just have it. You roll into your lines, and you want to have the momentum where you can make it rough for the Sharks to get up the ice. Even if you don't score on this, and as McNeil comes back, you want to just have the momentum. McNeil just used the reach, gets it in front, knocked away Zuccarelli. Toms trying to get control. Toms, oh, what a pretty move to get control. Graham towards the net. Kaiser smartly comes out with Bill Spillane. Ryan and Riccio on the faceoff. Riccio wins it. Zuccarelli fans on it, but recovers. Throws a bad pass out. Eddie Norton shot. Blocked Tim Cruz. Tim Cruz has had a big day blocking shots up in front. Cleared out by Riccio. Nelson slides it across. Curry. John Curry going back for Ed Norton. And it's flipped down by Norton, and no icing on the play. Zuccarelli goes back for it. 1:45 left in regulation. 10 seconds left. The penalty, now Riccio starts up the ice. Saints made it easy for Art Riccio
they
to
really
come
did.
Up the
Jeff
ice.
Nelson was back in his own zone, and Art Riccio just walked right by
him. I mean,
him.
This is too easy, and Zuccarelli nearly trailing, walked in and got a great shot off.
Great shot off. There's Cruz with a shot.
That was too easy. Cruz, 1:24 left, empty net down this
Art
end
Riccio
of the ice.
All alone in front of Justin Stratton with 1:20 left.
Riccio.
Goaltender's out awful early right now.
Yeah,
for the
it
Sharks.
Is. Nelson, Zuccarelli on top of him. As now the Saints trying to get control.
Everybody's focusing on the puck, though. Nobody's really focusing on where the open guys for the Sharks are.
And a smart play and falling on the puck and tying it up was Paul Murphy. He fell on it because the Saints looked confused in their own end. They were just running around.
They were. If I was the Saints, I would consider that a little quick timeout now just to get your defensive assignment set up. And if we win the faceoff, just put it off the glass and skate to it.
1:06 left. Tom Shaughnessy, Art Riccio on the faceoff.
I'm actually going to have to leave you guys to present the trophy to the championship winner, whoever it is of this game, in a few minutes. But there it is.
Oh, almost a chance for the Sharks to tie it up. Toms will get to the puck.
Nice faceoff win right there by Riccio. Pushed it out to Petrosino on his backhand in front of the net.
Just bounced over a stick.
Just bounced over a stick. And again, the
and
the
Toms
Saints
can't get it out. Crawl.
Two guys on the Saints were already out of the zone, in the neutral zone. And
Shaughnessy sends
it
around
first.
As Petrosino gets it. Yes, now Zuccarelli from the blue line, and now Riccio will just...
Right past that Riccio, who was all over here. As we talked earlier on that weak side post.
And he just saw it bounce away. 30 seconds to go in regulation. Jammed in front and knocked loose. Dolan Bainey, 26 seconds left. Tom's trying to get control for the Saints. Trying to get it out of the zone. Elwood does a smart thing. He could have gone with the forehand, backhands it out. Zuccarelli, 16 seconds left. To center ice, where Riccio picks it up. 12 seconds left. Loose puck, crawl. Stolen, Toms. 7 seconds left. The Saints trying to hang on for the championship. They will win the championship. The Saints win the fall 2011 championship as they go out to a 2-0 lead with goals by Charles Ryan and Frank Elwood and hang on for a 2-1 win. As we will be back the Schick Hydro postgame show with the championship celebration for the Saints, the fall champs for 2011.